Good morning, boys and girls, colleagues, special guests, and most importantly, our honored veterans. I welcome you all to Martin Luther King's 6th Annual Veterans Day celebration. If you could please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing for the singing of My Country, 'Tis of Thee.
I pledge allegiance
celebration. We have a very special surprise. We have a very special, mysterious, maybe so, exciting presentation by Mrs. Wilton.
I would like Ms. Milton and Mrs. Halkiadakis to come on up to help present our new Blue Lion mascot. We have not had the opportunity to introduce who that will be. And for those of you that are familiar with Martin Luther King School, our mascot always leads us in not with rounds of applause, but with three roars in celebration of all of our learning and specific people. So do you want to share, Ms. Milton? Señorita Milton?
Sorry, I'm a little small. Hi, boys and girls. Ms. Halkiadakis and I had a really, really tough time this year. We had 6 finalists that we interviewed, and it took us a couple weeks to come up with an answer for who our Blue Lion should be. But we did come up with an answer, and we would love to announce that our new Blue Lion is Tahira Palmer.
Uniform. At the end of the year, you get to keep the t-shirt. Boys and girls, I'm looking for those crack flowers, and we want to congratulate Tahira. We're going to have her join us up here so that she can lead us in three roars. It will be her first time in doing this. So Tahira, congratulations, and we're so proud and so glad that you are representing us as our Blue Lion. Numbers, Mrs. Pearlstein, who is a councilwoman for Edison Township. And I also want to give a tremendous thanks to all our veterans here, who it's thanks to them that we could have wonderful learning experiences at Martin Luther King School, who uphold all our symbols in America, including our flag that we pledge to every single day as a community of learners, and also for all the freedoms. I also want to thank Mrs. Lynn Renda, and I will get to that at the closure of our meeting. But this is a very important day for me. It's always an emotional day. But I want to remind you of a book called Feathers and Fools by Mem Fox. And it's about a swan and a peacock, and about their families and their friends who had misunderstandings and had a war. And all the peacocks and all the swans died because they didn't respect each other. They didn't value each other. They were alike but they didn't respect our differences. But at the end of the story, there was a light, and there were two eggs. One was a peacock, and one was a swan. And when the eggs hatched, they had no idea of the wars that were laid before them or before they arrived, and they were friends. And so I always remember that story because I really think the world would be better if we all took time and listened to each other, used those 21st century skills of communication that are so easy to go out globally throughout the universe. I want to thank all of our veterans here. Some of them are known as the greatest generation. They served in World War II. Tom Brokaw, one of the newscasters, wrote a book about the greatest generation. And I think of when I was a little girl, your age, and all my men relatives came back from World War II, my father serving in New Guinea, my uncle, who got injured on the beaches of Normandy, another uncle who served in World War I, which was a long time ago. And then I thought of each generation that had wars because of misunderstandings, just like feathers and fools. So I always want you to remember that even though you disagree with somebody, I'm hoping that you will be the next generation, the next greatest generation, who listen to each other, who always act in kindness, but you also have to use your intellect and all your learning with that kindness in order for you all to be successful. You have to know how to thank people who came before you and gave you your freedoms. And so that's why we have our Veterans Day celebration in honor of them today. And again, a special thank you to Mrs. Renda, who really puts in so much effort that she was even named the Teacher of the Year from the VFW at the state level. So we're so proud of her. And I'm going to turn over the program to Mrs. Renda, who will introduce our esteemed guests.
Good morning again, boys and girls. I'd like to start my piece of the program with a reading of my favorite poem, Mommy, What is a Veteran? Because it'll put into perspective, boys and girls, who these wonderful people are. Mommy, what is a veteran? My child asked in an innocent way. And could she please explain to me why we have a Veterans Day? My mind searched for the adjectives that might help me clarify. Those people who, for their country, have looked death in the eye. I quickly grabbed the dictionary to see what Webster may have said, but one who served in the armed forces were not the words that I would choose. But how do you describe a veteran? Heroes you've never met, those you'll never know the names of yet, but never will forget. How do you describe a veteran? How do you convey a definition for those who have brought this country's dreams to their ultimate fruition? How do you describe a veteran? Strangers who fought for you, men and women who risked their lives for people they never knew. How do you describe a veteran and the sacrifices they made so that you and your children's children could live free and unafraid? How do you describe a veteran for a child's sake? You say, a veteran is a person to whom we owe every breath we take. And boys and girls, these are the men and women that we owe every breath we take to. And today's program is dedicated to our wonderful honored veterans. Now I'd like to introduce Mrs. Pearlstein from the Mayor's Office in Edison.
Good morning, boys and girls, and good morning all of our veterans that are here today. Mayor Thomas Lankey was very sorry he could not make it. He had a family emergency, but we all extend to each and every one of our veterans that are here today, and even those that aren't, our sense of gratitude for your sacrifice and your dedication to our country. And one of the things that I want to just remind everybody about is that while we celebrate Veterans Day, and it's one day in November that we take the time to honor all of your service and all of your dedication, we really need to remind ourselves every day that without your hard work, your sacrifice, and also that of your families, we would not have the freedoms we enjoy every single day. So boys and girls, I want to leave you with one thought. You guys did a great job when you pledged allegiance and when you sang My Country 'Tis of Thee. And what I want to remind you of is every day that you do that in school, I want you to think of all of these veterans here and other people either in your family or that you know that are serving our country now. And think of them and make that be your inspiration for singing the song the best that you can and pledging allegiance the best that you can, okay? And with that, I want to say thank you for inviting us today. It's a wonderful ceremony. And again, thank you all for your service, your hard work and dedication. And you really are true heroes to all of us here. Thank you.
Next, I'd like to introduce Dr. O'Malley, Superintendent of Schools.
Good morning, boys and girls. I want to let you know how honored I am to be participating in your wonderful assembly. Veterans Day is a very important day, and as the last speaker said, it's not just one day. You have to remember how much people have given, not only their personal sacrifice, but of their families, so you get to enjoy the wonderful opportunities that you have, not only in school, but outside of school in this wonderful country. And so I want to thank Mrs. Wilton and all of the staff for putting this together. It's a wonderful assembly. Our special guests who came today to join us, and then most importantly, our veterans. We can't thank them enough for all they have done and what they continue to do today, what you don't see. And I really challenge each and every one of you this morning to really grasp onto one, at least one important fact that you can bring back every day that you feel is important about Veterans Day, and that every day should be Veterans Day. And if you see a veteran, you see them here joining us today, but if you see them on the ball field or in the supermarket, you need to every day thank them because it's a tremendous sacrifice that they gave us, so you get to enjoy the opportunities that you have right here in this wonderful country. So I hope you enjoy the assembly this morning and you participate. And again, I want to thank each and every veteran this morning on behalf of the school board members that are here, Mr. Shee and Mrs. Ames. Thank you for your dedication and your sacrifice that you've given to our country. And personally, thank you for all the opportunities that you've given me and my family as well. So thank you.
Thank you, Dr. O'Malley. Our first reading will be the History of Veterans Day, will be shared by Annika Santana, Student Council President.
The History of Veterans Day. Veterans Day, originally called Armistice Day, was first celebrated in 1938 to honor the soldiers that served in World War I. November 11th was picked as the date because the war ended at 11 a.m. on the 11th day of the 11th month in 1918. In 1954, after the U.S. had been involved in two additional wars, World War II and the Korean War, the holiday was renamed Veterans Day to honor the brave soldiers that had fought in all three wars. People often believe that Memorial Day and Veterans Day are celebrated for the same reason. There is, however, a subtle but important difference between the two. While both honor our military men and women, Memorial Day is a day to remember and pay respect to all the men and women that died serving our country in a war, while Veterans Day is to celebrate the soldiers who are still alive and served in the armed forces during peace or war. Several other countries around the world also celebrate this day. In France and New Zealand, they still call it Armistice Day. In the United Kingdom, Australia, and Canada, it is referred to as Remembrance Day, while Malta and South Africa celebrate it as Poppy Day. No matter what it is called, the reason for observing the day is the same: to show our gratitude to the brave men and women who sacrifice everything to make this world a safer place for you and me.
Thank you, Annika. Next up is Dev Parikh, Student Council Vice President, and he'll read a poem entitled Veterans Day.
Veterans Day, written by Cheryl Dawson. On Veterans Day, we honor all who answer to a service call. Soldiers young, soldiers old, fought for freedom, brave and bold. Some have lived while others have died, and all of us deserve our pride. We are proud of all the soldiers who kept thinking of the red, white, and blue. They fought for us and all our rights. And though we may not know each and every name, we thank all the veterans just the same.
Bring a tear to my eyes. But now is my favorite part of today's program. We get to meet these brave men and women who sit before us today. I'd like to introduce our veterans in attendance. So when your name is called, if you could salute or raise your hand so the children know who you are, we would appreciate that. Mr. Garrido, U.S. Marines. Mr. Dorr, U.S. Army. Mr. Frank Alec, U.S. Army. Mr. Daryl Steinbeck, U.S. Army. Mr. Conrad Venegas, U.S. Navy. Mr. Vincent Lupiano, U.S. Marines. Mr. Bieg, U.S. Seabees. Ms. Virginia Smith, U.S. Navy. Mr. Wawinski, U.S. Army. Mr. Robert Dagnella, U.S. Navy. Mr. Zimbler, U.S. Air Force. Ms. Reva Thomas, U.S. Army. Mr. Joe Gerlando, U.S. Army. Ms. Pauline Bisinski, U.S. Army nurse. Mr. Bill Young, U.S. Army. Mr. Ken Durkin, U.S. Army. Mr. Irv Bronstein, U.S. Army. Mr. John Zazula, U.S. Army. Mr. Willie Meisnest, U.S. Army. Oh, Meisner. I apologize, it was misspelled on my sheet. Mr. Peter Limprakos, U.S. Army. Mr. Ben Franco, U.S. Army. Dr. Samuel Galkin, U.S. Navy. Alex Fleischer, U.S. Army. Errol Meisner, U.S. Navy Marines. And Mr. Tim Brett Yansky, U.S. Navy. Now we'll hear a poem read by Rhea Sansguri, Student Council Secretary, entitled, They Did Their Share.
On Veterans Day, we honor soldiers who protect our nation. For their service as our warriors, they deserve our admiration. Some of them were drafted, some of them were volunteers. For some, it was just yesterday, for some, it's been many years. In the jungle or the desert, on land or on the sea, they did what was assigned to produce a victory. So came back, some didn't. They defended us everywhere. Some saw combat, some rode a desk. All of them did their share. No matter what the duty, for low pay and no glory, these soldiers gave up normal life for duties and mundane and gory. Let every veteran be honored. Don't let politics get in the way. Without them, freedom would have died, and what they did, we can't repay. We owe so much to them who kept us safe from terror. So when we see a uniform, let's say thank you to every wearer.
Thank you, Rhea. Next up is Annika with some very interesting Veterans Day statistics.
Veteran statistics. The brave men and women who serve and protect the U.S. come from all walks of life. They are parents, children, and grandparents. They are friends, neighbors, and co-workers, and an important part of their communities. Here are some facts about the current veteran population of the United States. Did you know? There are approximately 23.2 million military veterans in the United States. 9.2 million veterans are over the age of 65. 1.9 million veterans are under the age of 35. 1.8 million veterans are women. 7.8 million veterans served during the Vietnam War era, 1964 to 1975, which represents 33% of all living veterans. 5.2 million veterans served during the Gulf War, representing service from August 2, 1990 to present. 2.6 million veterans served during World War II, 1941 to 1945. 2.8 million veterans served during the Korean War, 1950 to 1953. 6 million veterans served in peacetime. As of 2008, 2.9 million veterans received compensation for service-connected disabilities. 5 states have more than 1 million veterans in among their population. California, 2.1 million, Florida, 1.7 million, Texas, 1.7 million, New York, 1 million, and Pennsylvania, 1 million. The VA healthcare system had 54 hospitals in 1930. Since then, it has expanded to include 171 medical centers, more than 350 outpatient, community, and outreach clinics, 126 nursing home care units, and 35 live-in care facilities for injured or disabled vets.
Thank you, Annika. Next up is Deb with another poem.
The Best on Earth, a Veterans Day Tribute by Joanne Futches. If someone's done a military service, they earn the title veteran and more. They earn our deep respect and admiration. They're special and no one can ignore. They sacrifice the comforts that we enjoy. The list is long of all the things they gave. Our veterans are extraordinary people. They're loyal, dedicated, true, and brave. When terrorist invasion, there are real threats. They showed us they can handle any storm. We owe our freedom and our very lives to our veterans who served in uniform. Our veterans should be celebrities. They're exceptional. No group compares. We are grateful for the many things they have done. They are always in our hearts and in our prayers. We owe our veterans support and friendship. Let no ever question what they're worth. These men and women served us and in our country. Our veterans are the very best on earth.
Thank you, Dan. Now I'd like to introduce Mr. Bill Young, Chief of Staff, State of New Jersey, Veterans of Foreign War.
Good morning. Before I have something to say, I'd like to call up Frank Alec and his team from the post, his post at Edison, the Veterans of Foreign Wars. Good morning, boys and girls. This is a special day to me in three different ways. First is this awesome program that you recognition for us veterans. It's a very good program, and it just makes my heart flutter. Second reason special about this day is we have the veterans from the Menlo Park Veterans Home, where every day is Veterans Day for them. The third is I'm so proud and honored to be here to make this presentation to Lynn Renna, who entered our Teacher of the Year contest last year at our VFW Veterans of Foreign Wars Post 3117. That's your Edison Memorial Post. And I'd like to make this presentation to Lynn Teacher. Lynn Renna, Teacher of the Year 2014-2015. I'll read what it says. Teachers change our society one day, one class lesson, one student at a time. There's no more important job, and there's no one who fulfills the role better. Thank you. And this is presentations from our national organization in the state of New Jersey and in our post. And it reads, Veterans of Foreign Wars, United States, 2014-2015, Smart Mayor VFW National Citizenship Education Teacher Award, elementary school level, awarded to Lynn Renda, Martin Luther King Elementary School, Edison, New Jersey, in recognition of being selected the state teacher winner in your grade level category. Signed by Commander-in-Chief John W. Stewart and Adjutant General John E. Hamilton. Lynn, congratulations.
Boys and girls, we're not finished yet. In addition, I'd like to have your principal, Mrs. Wilton, come forward. Mrs. Renda was honored in the month of February by the Department of New Jersey. She received some accolades at that time. She just received this nice proclamation from the Department of New Jersey as well as our national headquarters. But we also have a duplicate for the school right here, and it will go to our principal, Mrs. Wilton.
Thank you. Thank you. Dr. O'Malley.
Good morning to all the students here at Martin Luther King School, to all the teachers that are here, to your principal, Mrs. Wilton, and to our gracious host, Mrs. Renda, and a special good morning to all my comrades here who have served this great nation. My name is Mr. Young. I am a member of the Veterans of Foreign Wars, and I was in the United States Army 1969 to 1972. I served overseas in the Republic of Vietnam. I am a veteran. I'd like to introduce you to a few people here. Mr. Lupiano.
Good morning. My name is Vinny Lupiano. I served in Vietnam, and I served in the United States Marine Corps, and I am a veteran.
Thank you. Mr. Steinbeck.
My name is Daryl Steinbeck, and I'm an Army veteran.
Hello, boys and girls. My name is Ken Durkin. I served in the U.S. Army from 1970 to 1973 in the Republic of Vietnam and in the Republic of Thailand. I am a veteran.
Mr. Thor.
Good morning, students and faculty. My name is Rich Thor. I served the United States Army Signal Corps, a Vietnam veteran in the Army. Thank you.
You've heard these gentlemen. The question is, what is a veteran? A former member of the armed forces. Yes, a former member of the armed forces. A person who has experience in a branch of our services, the Army, the Navy, the Marines, the Air Force, Coast Guard, defending our nation. The question is, where would we be today if the United States had lost World War II. If Saddam Hussein had control of all the oil fields and all the countries in the Mideast. And finally, if terrorists in the Mideast could attack the United States at will. This is why we thank our veterans and honor them on Veterans Day. They are always making a wonderful future for all of you. God bless our troops. God bless this great nation, the United States of America. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We have two Board of Education members here with us today, Mrs. Ames and Mr. Shi. Would either of you or both of you like to speak or say a few words? Thank you. Ms. Vache?
Welcome. veterans. What an honor it is. You may be tired of hearing me say it, but I came to Martin Luther King School in September of 1970 with my three children, well, three of my children, when the school doors opened. Martin Luther King has been a beacon for veterans, for those of us who love our country, those of us who love our community. So thank you, Mrs. Renda, Mrs. Wilton, all the staff, teachers, students, for everything you do, and for this wonderful representation and remembrance every single year. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Siciliano. Our final poem will be read by Rhea, and it's entitled, Protecting Us.
Protecting Us by Joanna Fuchs. While we were home on our comfortable sofas, munching and watching TV, our veterans were fighting our battles in situations we certainly flee. Would keep us all safe is what they were called to do. Rough duties of every kind, protecting us, me, and you. So when you see vets, please thank them for their service and sacrifice. Be aware and always remember, for us they paid a price.
Thank you, Leah. Now, Mrs. Wilton.
Once again, I want to thank our veterans, and I do like that. I am a daughter of a veteran, a niece of a veteran, and a mother of two veterans. So thank you. They served with the U.S. Marine Corps, one enlisted and one officer. And I also want to give a wholehearted thank you to Mrs. Renda. We have some flowers for her. Mrs. Renda, I want to thank her team for putting this on every year. This is the sixth year running. And boys and girls, I want to thank you for being such a patient audience. You really used your etiquette. And I'm going to look when you're leaving, who's going to get proud clouds. Right now, all the teachers will get proud clouds in their mailboxes for you. And I want to thank Whispering Knolls for bringing their veterans, and I want to thank the Menlo Park Home for bringing their veterans to share with us. I also want to thank the support from Dr. O'Malley and the Board of Education, Board of Deborah Ames. I think you've been here just about every single time. Mr. Shee, you've been here so often, and it's so nice to have you here. And Dr. O'Malley, thank you. And Mrs. Pearlstein, a special thank you. But most importantly, thank you, veterans. You're truly honored guests today at Martin Luther King School. Thank you.